This question belongs to Engineering Mathematics subject and was asked in GATE CSE 2020. So the question states, which one of the following predicate formula is not valid? Note that W is a predicate formula without any free occurrence of X. So we have option A, for all X, PX or W is equivalent to for all X, PX or W. Okay, so here actually we have removed W out of this for X range. Can it be done? Logically it can be done, as it is given that W is a formula without any free occurrence of X. So W do not have any X. Can you verify it? Yes. Suppose W is always true, then for all the values we will have for all X we will have PX or true. So it will be true by default. And what will be RHS? It will be for all X PX or true. So whatever may be the left hand side, either true or false, this true will make it always true. So it is true. If we assume W as false, then for or false, so it can be neglected. So it will becomes equivalent to for all X PX. So as it depends on the PX value. And right hand side, for all false, so false can be neglected. So it depends on the for all X PX value. So both LHS and RHS are equal in both true and false conditions. So A are equivalent. LHS and RHS is equivalent. Let us see option B. Let me clear this out. So we have option B as there exist X, PX and W is equivalent to there exist X, PX and W. Similarly here, as W is independent of X, it can be removed out. Let us verify it with same true and false. If it is true, then left hand side is true. So there exist X, PX and true. So and means it will depend on the PX value. So it gets simplified to there exist X, PX. And right hand side and true. So true means it simplifies to the left hand side. There exist PX. So both are equal. In the false case, and false. False means it is always false. So left hand side will always come out to be false. And here also whatever may be this value, and false means it will always turn out to be false. So it is true for both true and false. Thus option B is also correct. They are equivalent. Let us see option C. Option C states, for all X, PX implies W is equivalent to for all X, PX implies W. What if A implies B? A implies B is equivalent to negation of A or B. So similarly, applying the same case here, we get for all X, negation of PX or W. And right hand side can be written as for all X, PX, its negation or W. Okay, now what we can write for the this one, see. Negation of for all is there exist and negation of there exist is for all. So we can bring this negation outside. So how will we do this? So we can do it something like, it will turn out to be negation of there exist X, PX or W if we take it forward out. Okay, and it can be written as negation of there exist X. So it can be written as there exist X, PX implies W. So this is this, and right hand side is for all X, PX implies W. So they are logically also not correct. Here it is for all, here there is there exist. So option C is false. Let us see option D. So option D states there exist X, PX implies W, and here for all X, for all X. So what we can do? We can similarly apply the same condition. There exist X, PX implies W can be written as negation of PX or W. Now this negation can be brought forward, and this one can, right hand side can be written as negation of for all X, PX or W. So if we, using the De Morgan's law, if we bring this negation outward, then it will be for all X, PX or W. And this, using this formula, can be written as, assuming this as A and this as B, it is A implies B, which is for all X, PX implies W. So this one and this one are both equivalent. So options D is also correct. Now it is asking which of the following is not logically valid. So A, B and D are logically valid and C is not logically valid. So not logically valid is option C. So option C is the correct answer.